I was 10 when it came out, so I was just a little bit too young. But one of the older kids on our estate had a copy of it, and it was known that somebody had an album with swearing on it. It's like, what? I remember hearing Bodies with a heroic amount of bad language in that song, and thinking, wow, you know. And I have to say, if push comes to shove, it's probably the greatest album of all time. And people might think it's a bit of an odd thing to say, but without that album, I don't think any of us would be doing what we're doing now. And particularly modern guitar music now comes from that record and from that band. Easily one of the top two bands ever, ever. And I still get excited when I see things on the TV when they're on, like a classic albums or a documentary, and still watch it. It still moves me. And I think for that band to only have been going for 2.5 years and to change music, I mean, not many bands get to change the way that people dress, talk, and feel and a culture, you know. Not many bands get to do that, if any. If you consider that John was, what, 18 when he wrote Anarchy in the UK? I mean, that's still to this day is staggering. His lyrics are, for such a young lad, unbelievable. If you listen to it now, it sounds like it could be recorded yet tomorrow. Do you know what I mean? There's a spirit to it that is undeniable. To say what he said in such a short space of time, and they're pop songs as well. It's right up there with all the great pop records that you can think of, from the Beatles to the Stones to Elvis to Buddy Holly, the Kinks, all the way through. That album is right, sits right at the top. I got it every time I'm asked about my favourite album of all time. That's it for me, because if it wasn't for that, you wouldn't have had Definitely Maybe. No way. Absolutely no way. The sound is the sound we were going for, you know. So it's like any great music, it just is. The artwork is iconic, you know. The story of the Sex Pistols is iconic. The clothes that they wore have become iconic, you know. The people around them went on themselves to become iconic, like Susie Sue and, you know, Billy Idol and Sid Vicious and all they started a thing, you know what I mean? It just is. And on its 50th anniversary, we'll still be talking about it. And on its 70th, you know. I do look back at when I watch old footage of the Sex Pistols and I see photographs. I really wish I'd have seen them in 75 or 76 or 77 at their height. You know, we all got to see them afterwards when they reformed and all that. I wish I'd have seen them when it really, really meant something, you know. But I'm glad they're still around, you know. I don't have many heroes, and I'm not like a fanboy kind of thing, but he's one of the special ones, you know. So there you go. The greatest, I think, Sex Pistols.